One of the most common design patterns for multi-threaded applications is the producer-consumer model. This can be viewed as a special case of one of the models discussed before, if you like. To motivate our discussion, we'll use a tracking application. Here's our camera. Maybe it's monitoring the number of people on a subway platform to help route trains or something like that. We can then break the computation down into two pieces. One is to get the picture from the camera into the memory. We'll call this the producer task. And the other task is to analyze the picture to figure out where all the people are and pass this information onto the train planner or whoever may need it. We'll call this the consumer task. Now for this scenario, suppose that images are available from the camera every 33 milliseconds. We want to get all of them, so we're going to have a thread whose job is just to copy the frame from the camera into computer memory. And let's say that the image processing to find the people is variable, taking somewhere between 20 and 40 milliseconds, but on average less than 33. If it were more than 33, we could put more consumer threads here to do the work. Because of the variability in the time it takes to process the image, we need a place in which to store images that our consumer thread is not yet ready to handle. And for this, we'll use a ring buffer. Each division here represents memory for a frame from the camera. The ones that haven't been consumed yet, I've colored in red. And we should imagine the producer and consumer threads chasing each other around this ring, with the producer one writing frames, making them red, and the consumer one running behind, turning them back to white, that is, empty or processed. Though, of course, the consumer will never pass the producer.